What's good YouTube? ReShockman, aka Rock Hard Fitness. And if you see me in this black chair over here, in my office at the Rock Hard HQ, then you know it's going to be a sit-down video where I talk to you. However, in this video, it's going to be a full push day. So that's chest, shoulders, and triceps. Now guys, this workout is going to be for an intermediate to advanced lifter. So pretty much if you've been training between three and above years. So if you've done that, then you can hit this workout. If you are a beginner and still want to give this workout a try, then what I recommend is you take out either one or two of the exercises and also just lower the volume slightly. Now this is all going to be according to you and how you recover. If you feel that you don't recover by your next push day, then you know you're doing too much volume. So guys, without further ado, let's get into the video. Also, I apologize if you hear a lot of this. And that's because I'm kind of sick. I don't know if I am sick or if I'm not sick or if it's just allergies because it is cold outside now and inside kind of. So yeah, usually when it's change of season and all of that stuff, then my nose does flare up quite a bit. So I'm sorry if I go, it's not, I don't know why I go, But anyway, guys, so let's get started on this amazing push workout, chest, shoulders, and so the first exercise I want you guys to do is an incline dumbbell press. Now I realize, guys, I have two push workouts in a week. And usually the first workout I'll start out with an incline barbell because that's just my personal preference. But in this workout, I want you guys to do incline dumbbell press. The reason being is because it's just an overall great upper chest and lower chest, if you didn't know. Because a lot of people just think because you're doing incline, you're not hitting your lower chest. And if you're just doing flat or decline, you're hitting your upper chest. Remember guys, your chest is one total muscle. So if you do incline, my lower chest is still contracting. If you're doing decline, my upper chest is still contracting. Just not a great amount. You're putting more emphasis on one area of the chest than the other. But anyway guys, key tips with this is make sure that you shrug up, retract the scapula, and then when you come down, I want you to come down pretty much to your anterior delts. And the reason why we're doing this is so we can get full range of motion. And also you must realize, the chest performs best under a great stretch and full range of motion. So don't skimp out of on the exercise, but just doing this form over here. Make sure you're getting a nice deep stretch and full extension. Not lockout, but extension. The reason why we don't lockout is because that puts all the emphasis from our chest onto our joints, and we do not want that. We want all the emphasis and the stimulation on our muscle. The next exercise we're going to do is another chest exercise and also another upper chest emphasis chest exercise. The reason why we do a lot of upper chest work as bodybuilders is because you'll never have too much upper chest. Now, a lot of people do have a tendency to overdevelop their lower chests, and this is because the lower chest does tend to grow a lot quicker than your upper. So for this specific reason, we do a lot of upper chest movements, and this will include things like your incline dumbbell and this exercise over here, which is called the incline landmine press. Now the keys with this exercise, guys, is you don't want, when you come down, you don't want your elbows to flare out. What this is going to do is put unnecessary pressure on your wrists, your elbows, and your anterior delt. And that's totally not what we want. What you want to do is you want to make sure that you're actually keeping your elbows underneath you. And when you're coming down to that point where you're not touching your upper chest, but pretty close, and then push upwards, hold it there, come down slowly to your chest, push up and repeat. You will feel a great contraction in that upper chest and also your inner chest. Now remember, you can't target things like your inner middle chest and your inner upper chest, but when you develop the muscle as a whole, these areas will grow. And I just feel that I feel it here in this area of my chest the most. So mind muscle, hopefully it'll grow there because I do have a bit of it's a t-shirt that you can't see. But anyway, then the next exercise we're gonna do is, listen to this, a very low seated chest press machine. Now, the reason why we put the seat actually all the way down is so that our elbows go from this pretty much to this. Now, remember, you never want to actually flare your elbows to this degree. However, we are doing relatively lightweight in the about 10 to 15 rep range. And the reason why the seat is all the way down is because in this plane, you're going to be hitting a lot of upper chest, and it's almost turning into something sort of a guillotine press, but I feel it's a lot safer on that anterior delt and the upper chest, and you won't get injured as easily or at all if you just stay wise. Remember, These aren't movements that you want to go super heavy on, but you want to do enough weight just to get that nice, sweet contraction. Remember guys, we are bodybuilders. These are bodybuilding workouts, so the whole aim of the game is to grow muscle, not to show off how strong you are. Progressive overload is something you need to grow muscle, but we do progressive overload with perfect form, a good tempo, and good speedy reps. So for instance, if you do a rep, it must be like 1, 2, 3, up, 1, 2, 3, up. That shows that you have both control and contraction in the muscle. So after those three upper chest movements in a row, we're gonna finally move on to a lower chest exercise. Well, not lower specifically, but we're gonna do a cable fly with the attachment set up at about shoulder height or just up, just above. The reason why we do this is so that we can actually fly to our lower area of the chest. And guys, this is one of the best exercises you can do for your chest as a whole. The primary function of your chest is to try and get your humerus across your sternum. So basically this motion, and what is it exactly? It's a fly. So guys, a fly is really gonna shorten your pec the most, and it's gonna give you the greatest stimulation, and also you can get a nice, great mind-muscle connection. And now because it is an isolation movement, we are gonna work within the 12 to 15 rep range, because we're only gonna be working one muscle. And also on this one, you can push a little bit closer to failure and maybe like go to failure. However, don't go to that form of complete form breakdown. So whenever I ever say go to failure, guys, what I mean is go to that point where form starts to break down. Not complete muscular failure, but form failure. This will again prevent any injuries and keep you in the gym for longer. Now we've finished with chest, we've done the upper and the lower, and everything's covered. Now with all these presses, you're gonna be hitting a lot of anterior delt. Therefore, I don't put anterior delts or front delts in any of my workouts because it's just not necessary. And remember, you wanna build a nice, complete shoulder. So you wanna have a lot of side delt and a lot of rear delt work. That's why the next exercise we're gonna do is one of my personal favorites, and I'm gonna call it the cable rear delt fly because I can't think of a better name, to be honest. Now basically guys, with this one, you wanna actually come from above and pull with the elbows. So it is gonna be like if you're doing a cable fly, just think of that in reverse. So instead of flying to the front, you're gonna be flying to the back, pulling. So what you wanna do is you wanna keep a nice angle between your forearm, your wrist, and your shoulder joint, and just pull backwards. Now remember, it's not a row, so you're not gonna be like pulling the weight like this. You're gonna be keeping that angle throughout and making sure you get a nice squeeze on the rear delt. With things like rear delts and side delts and all those muscles, which people do struggle to grow, I highly recommend that your training partner, if you have one, actually palpate the area that you're trying to work. This really does help with that mind-muscle connection, and you just get a great feeling. Myself and Brandon always do it to each other. No, we're not being weird in the gym, we're just trying to get the most out of our exercises. Now after the rear delt flies, I want you to do dumbbell side raises with perfect form and perfect tempo. Now, you can go heavy on side raises and slightly bend the arms and rep it out like this. However, with a lot of people who do have lagging delts, I see this way too much, and that's because they're trying to lift with the ego and not with the muscle. Now I can do side raises with up to 16 kgs, and my shoulders are well developed. However, I've got very good genetics for shoulders. If you're not as lucky as me, then you've got to concentrate on actually working that side delt, guys. Put the weight away, grab those 6 kg dumbbells, and literally keep the arms as straight as possible, slight bending them, and then raise it to the side and lower it down. Perfect form and a good tempo of side raises. Do a little pause at the top, and I'm telling you guys, your delts will burn so much, you're gonna wanna run, cry to your mothers, and say, "Mama, help me, I don't know what to do." So that's the shoulder portion of the workout done, and now we're gonna move into a bit of triceps. Now guys, with triceps, it's the same sort of thing that applies with the shoulders. When you're doing your chest movements, most chest exercises are compound exercises. So what that means is you're hitting more than one muscle group at a time. So when you're doing the bench press, you're not just working chest, but you're working anterior delt and tricep too. So when I do triceps, all I do is two exercises. Specifically, I like to do a shoulder flex exercise and a push down. Now in this workout, I haven't put a shoulder flex because that I do on my first push day, which I will make a video of in the future. However, this is just what I did on this day. So the first tricep exercise we're gonna do is machine dips. Now, I love machine dips over bodyweight dips or weighted dips because I feel that I can work my triceps a lot better. The mind-muscle connection I get with this machine compared to a bodyweight dip or something is very good, and it doesn't irritate my elbows at all. So what I do here is I like to do about 3 sets, 10 to 12, go as heavy as possible, but also keep that good tempo going and not hyperextending the elbow. The most important thing with any thrust exercise is not to hyperextend the elbow. We want to go to full lockout, which is this, but we don't want to go to hyperextension, which is this. Because guys, from here to here, you don't get that much extra benefit. You might get a little bit of extra stimulus, however, it's going to take 5 years off your gym time. Just saying. You can do it if you want to. I highly recommend you do not hyperextend though. Just go just slightly short of lockout and you will build tremendous triceps. Trust me, I got you. Now the final exercise we have of this day is rope tricep pushdowns. Now with this exercise, I like to go between the 12 to 15 rep range and also get a nice pause at the bottom and a good tempo on the way up. Now, I remember on this day, I was crying because guys, like I say, the volume, it's pretty high for myself personally, and it's just a very fun workout. However, it does make you cry. At the end of this workout, especially my triceps were so sore, I didn't know what to do. It's like I tried to stretch them and then nothing was working. But keys you want to do with the tricep pushdowns is you actually want to stay retracted. So you don't want to be hunching over like this, because this is going to utilize front delt and chest, which is going to make the tricep exercise easier. But remember, it's a tricep exercise and not a chest or a shoulder exercise. So the key with this is keep the shoulders retracted, just shrug up, pull them back, and you want to keep your elbows underneath your shoulders. This is going to make sure that you use just your triceps and give you the best bang for your buck and not use any of the other muscle groups, so you can build that balanced aesthetic physique. So guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed this video, because guys, it's so much fun making these videos because I can just be myself. You guys seem to enjoy my personality. I like giving you my personality because it's me. I don't have to put on a show. I don't have to do stupid stuff that I don't want to do, because the stupid stuff I do is what the stupid stuff I do is what I want to do. So thank you very much for all the support. Please don't forget to give this video a like. Comment down below what video you want to see next. Maybe a pull day, maybe a leg day. Leg day. But yeah, whatever you guys want, I'll film it for you. I'll give you all that knowledge I can. I'll give you some entertainment as well. I'll try. But anyway, guys, thanks very much. And I hope you have a great day, night, weekend, holiday. Baklava is a food. Can't say that. Anyway, thanks. Bye.